Hello everyone, this is Professor Bushra Ansari, back with another session completing your Unit 3, that is managing your expatriation and repatriation, with a very short and very simple video covering two main things, and that's where we are talking about role of expatriate and then what are the reasons for having these all together, these international assignments. Now firstly, when you talk about the role of an expatriate, like in my previous session we were discussing about role of an repatriate. He brings in foreign knowledge, he brings in so many, say, cultural new things, technological knowledge and such kind of things. Same way, when I talk about my expatriate, he is firstly and foremost a source of a direct control. When I say direct control, if I am here and then I am sending, say, my best friend to my subsidiary office, it's like a direct control. I know I gel up with her or him, and he or she is going to give me the first hand information. So there's no manipulation, there is no hiding of information. So my control on the business, on the activity, on the whole responsibility, it's quite strong. Same way, an expatriate is also an agent of socializing. So it's like connecting to cultures. You have an individual working over here, going over there, coming back and all sort of things, and then you're connecting. The person gets to socialize with the people out there, creating a different bond and an image about your own country culture in another country. And then I am talking about an individual who's going to take up a lot of knowledge or competency from here, and then this person who is kind of, say, going over there, he was going to transfer this knowledge and competency. So suddenly people get to know, oh wow, Indians are so talented. They have got so much of knowledge. They have got so much of dedication in doing their work. They're so workaholic. They're not like us. They're not like the lookalikes. And you are going global with this. And this happens because when you are dealing or mingling with the localites over there, they get to create. When you go out in another country, you are not a XYZ individual. You are not an individual coming from Navi Mumbai, coming from Bombay, coming from Delhi, Gujarat or something. You are an Indian. Whatever you do, it's going to be an Indian person doing this. Same thing, we need to know that as an individual, you are giving out a lot of, say an image about the country, and that's where we say an individual to be, say, boundary spanner. You are, say, crossing the boundaries, creating that kind of image and some impression on the other country. And then you are talking about communication, the language connectivity, acting as a language node. So you are acting as a medium of interaction between two parties. That's the whole way when we talk about the role of an expatriate. This individual tries to be a factor or a element for the company, where he is acting as the point of contact for the parent company. I hope this is clear enough, because when you talk about an expatriate and a repatriate, we end up thinking and lot many common things. But understand, a repatriate is the person coming back to home country, an expatriate going to a foreign country. And then what makes these company actually come up with these international assignments? Sometimes I need to do position filling. I need to have an individual. When I'm saying position filling, I need to go and make someone fulfill the vacant place in another subsidiary. So I have HR manager over here, and then my office in Dubai, I don't have an HR manager. So I pick you up and I send you to Dubai. So that's position filling. I might look into, say, management development. So I'm talking about hierarchy. I'm talking about having more kind of people in the hierarchy. I'm talking about organizational development. I don't have any position. I am starting a new office in Germany. I'm starting a new office in London. So I need people, and that's where I want people to move from here, this country, to that country. Anything can be a reason for an international assignment, because at the end of the day, it's company's expenses. So if company is doing this, obviously they have got a lot of logic and idea behind it. that was all about me talking expatriation and repatriation in detail. Just to give you a brush up or a rewind or a recap thing, we're talking about an expatriate, the person moving from one country to another country for work purpose. We spoke about the various factors that goes into expatriation, the limitations, advantages and challenges. And then we spoke about repatriation, where the individual is coming back after terminating his work assignment, coming back to the home country, the parent country. So what challenges he faces, the cultural diversity, adjustment to the time and so many things. And lastly, this factor of understanding the role of an expatriate and how an international assignment is supposed to be done, why it is supposed to be taken up. So this was all about your unit 3 in a very small and a crisp manner to understand who an expatriate is and repatriate is. Thank you for watching.